giving people the ability to respond to content by clicking on one of 12 emojis, it dramatically increased their level of engagement. From that, we took that methodology and applied it broadly across the internet and found that emoji was a helpful tool to A, increase engagement by consumers, but help us evaluate their sentiment towards the things that they see. Most consumers don't respond to things they see online, right? 99% to be exact. And we're eliciting emotional responses from a large proportion of people who were prior silent. And what we're able to understand now is their preferences and the degree of interest to different products, services, things, etc. And so we can understand whether a piece of content or a product or a service makes them excited, if they love it, if it's not stirring any emotion at all. And what's even more fascinating is that we're able to take these emotional responses and map it to interesting things that the marketer is trying to understand, like that consumer's likelihood to purchase something if they engage with you emotionally in a certain way. What this means for the companies that we work with, they're going to have to integrate emojis into their strategies, into their digital platforms and strategies for the purpose of better connecting with their with the consumer. We've seen a lot of companies, Facebook being one of the recent ones, that made a shift in their platform strategy from the most basic level to integrate emojis, right? They redefined the like button to be emojis because it was so important. And we're seeing other firms as well follow suit, like Twitter with their announcement and Uber with their announcement as well, changing the five-star system to emoji. And the reason being is because it's really, at the core, it's all about tapping into the consumer's emotions and preferences. And emoji has emerged as the perfect vehicle for doing that. And our clients are finding that it's driving a lot of value for them. What we have built is the emotion graph, and that is understanding a consumer's preference to anything. So we take emotional responses to content, ads, emails, etc., and we associate and build these robust profiles about the user's preferences based on their emotion. Emoji is the first platform capable outside of social media to build such a robust platform of consumer preferences. It was pretty remarkable being added to Forbes 30 Under 30 for marketing and advertising because of the fact that it validates what we do here every single day, right? We are relentlessly trying to understand and capture consumer emotion for the purpose of improving the online experience for them as they browse and view content on the internet.